Anne McKay et je suis chef de la restauration au Musée McCord. La restauration est au cœur du mandat du musée. Nous nous préoccupons avec la préservation, l'étude et le traitement de nos objets. Et comme nous sommes un musée d'histoire sociale, nos objets sont les objets de la vie quotidienne. Ils ont été utilisés, portés, collectionnés et ils ont une histoire à raconter. We can all imagine how objects have lives before they enter a museum. They're created, they're bought, they're sold, and they're used. But objects continue to live after they enter a museum, and as a conservator, I feel like I'm very much part of this chapter in an object's biography. Objects bear the marks of their life on their body. For example, when a painting deteriorates, its varnish becomes dirty and yellowed and cracked. We see marks of use on an object, and one of my favorite examples of this is wear on a well-loved toy. We can also see how objects are altered in the past. We worked recently on a series of baskets that were mended, or we can see how garments have been altered. And this allows us to understand how objects were valued in the past and how they were cared for. As a conservator, I'm of course very interested in materials, and materials are always my starting point. I look at what an object is made of and how it is made. But after that, in order to be able to undertake a treatment, I have to delve more into an object's materiality. In other words, how it's lived in the world and how it has come through time to us. Conservators actually change objects during treatment, and over the course of the last number of years, we've developed codes of ethics and certain procedures that really force us to think about what we're doing and why we're doing it. For example, I would never use a material that's stronger than the object I'm working on because I don't want to harm that object. I also, for example, would want to be sure that whatever I do to an object can be removed in the future if our ideas about that object change, or if we find a better way of conserving the object. And certainly I would want to make sure that whatever I do is visible to the attentive viewer so that there's no idea of trying to fool the viewer into thinking that this object is in a completely undamaged or unchanged state. Before we undertake a treatment, we always research as much as possible an object so we know what it is we're trying to conserve or what we're trying to preserve. Alors, notre but pendant un traitement n'est pas nécessairement de retrouver l'original, mais c'est plutôt de voir comment l'objet a vécu le temps. Alors, on conçoit un traitement vraiment que le monde puisse comprendre l'objet et que cet objet ait un sens pour nous aujourd'hui. Objects very often are cooperative and they really work with us. They allow us to find out certain things. For example, we can study pigments and dyes to know when an object was made or when it was repaired. So objects in their materiality give us a lot of clues about themselves. But also sometimes during treatment, an object will refuse something and will actually push back. And a certain procedure that we thought would work, in fact, doesn't work, and we have to find another way of approaching the object. I find with most objects, in fact, you never really get to the bottom of what that object was. There's always a little piece that an object keeps to itself. It always has the last word.